This video is strictly for educational purposes only. I do not condone or glorify the usage of drugs.
Yo, what is good? I'm Lil Key Fish, and in this video, I'll be covering the substance called Clonazepam. This is a prescription medication that yields similar effects to other benzodiazepines such as Xanax and Valium. I'll explain everything, including the dangers, effects, history, pharmacology, and everything else in between. Let's get into it. Clonazepam is a long-acting psychoactive substance of the benzodiazepine class. It produces anxiolytic, anticonvulsant, muscle relaxant, amnesic, sedative, depressant, and hypnotic effects. It is commonly used and FDA approved for the medical treatment of panic disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, and social anxiety disorder. It's sold under the brand name Clonopin, but is frequently referred to as K-pins due to its slang term catching popularity in the streets. Clonazepam binds to the GABA-A receptors, thus increasing the effect of the chief inhibitory neurotransmitter, GABA. It works by decreasing abnormal electrical activity in the brain. It has an intermediate onset of action with a peak blood level occurring 1 to 4 hours after oral administration. The effects last about 6 to 12 hours, give or take, once the effects kick in. Originally patented in 1960, Clonazepam went on sale in 1975 in the United States. It is available as a generic medication, and in 2019, it was the 46th most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 15 million prescriptions being handed out. In many areas of the world, it is commonly used as a recreational drug. The drug is dispensed by either taking tablets or liquid drops, although sometimes it is administered by doctors through injection. A light dose is deemed as a quarter to a half of a milligram, and a common dose is a half to a full milligram, while a strong dose is 1 to 2 milligrams or more. If the user has a history of prolonged daily usage, he or she can experience withdrawal effects if stopped cold turkey. This can be quite uncomfortable, so it is generally recommended to taper off K-pins if wanting to quit. Additionally, it can be dangerous if combined with other downers such as alcohol or ketamine. Just like every other benzodiazepine, if abused, K-pins can yield a foggy and a clouded headspace. This is quite the opposite of phenodiazepines, which are clear-headed and don't bring you down as much. If you want to learn more about phenodiazepines, watch this video next, which will explain everything there is to know about etizolam. Etizolam yields anti-anxiety effects similar to clonazepam, but doesn't bring you down or cloud your headspace as much. My name is Fish, and I stay low-key. Peace out.